What point? If your enjoying of the group of the good is evil itself, what good? So let your enjoying of the good be good, and your prohibition of the evil to be to not to be evil. The individual, he is not only he is a jahil, but he is a jahil murakkab, that individual. Because istidlalu min al-Qur'an bi ghayri burhan, using the Qur'an as a dalil without no insight, this is, you are placing many people upon misguidance. And you all know that we live in a day when a person start quoting a verse or two, people will think that he's a scholar. You quote one verse or two, you say, man, this guy is, alhamdulillah, he is learned. Man, this guy, we knew him 2 years ago, man.
Ahi, stop it.
We know this guy a few years ago, he, you know, but now he's quoting verse left and right. It doesn't take much to quote verses. Not at all. Right? Any of the kids, you start a verse, they finish it for you. Right, Abu? Any of the verse, you start a verse, he will finish it for you. So the Ibra Barakallah is not about, you know, I can just quote. I can recite. Let us not be us. Let us not be fooled by a person just quoting. Al-ilm laysa bi kathrati riwaya. Knowledge is not how many riwaya, how many verses you can quote, how many hadith you can quote. But knowledge is barakallah fikum, is that which is memorized and understood. And yarhamukallah, when we say understood, ala fahm as-salaf, upon the understanding of the salaf as-salih. So the Shaykh hafidhahullah, he say, if the ummah, this ummah, the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is the best of the nation, tayyib, huwa hiya ashrafu al-umam, is the best of the nation, faman dunaha min babil awla. So therefore, فَمَنْ دُونَهَا مِنْ بَابِ الْأُولَىٰ. So therefore, anything that is lesser than this ummah, of course, if the best of the ummah will be asked, then without a doubt, those who are lesser than them will be asked. If the best student will be put into a test, then what about the most da'if students? They will test them too. So if the best of the ummah will be asked in the grave, if the best ummah will be to punish in the grave, then without a doubt, then those who are smaller or lesser in value or in virtue than them. Now, a third thing that we wanted to mention in regard to this was, how about those who die, barakallahu fikum, mathalan, they were not being buried? Because here the statement of Ibn Taymiyyah was, "Inna fa inna nasa yuftanuna fi quburihim." He say in their graves. Hakada? In their graves. But how about those who, yani, they were burnt to ashes? How about those who, barakallahu fikum, they drowned in the sea? Or how about those who have been eaten by the animals, by the wild animals? How about those who, barakallahu fikum, they died in a point that nobody could see them? Their body, what you call, degraded, and he became into pieces and nobody could see him. How about those? Well, Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he mentioned and explained in the statement of Ibn Taymiyyah, fi quburihim, in their graves, he say, quburihim jam'a qabr. Qubur jam'a qabr. It is the plural form of qabr, meaning the tomb or the grave. Wahiya mudfanul amwat, and it is the place where the deceased one will be buried. Wal murad, and what is intended, ma huwa a'am. So therefore, what is intended is not just the grave. وَالْمُرَادْ مَا هُوَ أَعَمْ. What is intended is not just Those who are buried will be asked. But anyone, barakallahu fikum, that die in this life of the barzakh is established, they will be asked. And he mentioned this. He say, فَيَشْتَمِلْ أَوْ فَيَشْمِلْ الْبَرْزَخْ وَهُوَ مَا بَيْنَ الْمَوْتُ الْإِنسَانِ وَقِيَامِ السَّاعَةِ. And al-barzakh is that which is between the death of the individual and the establishment of the hour. This is what you call the barzakh. Meaning that waiting period that people would be in after they die before the establishment of the hour. Now he says, سَوَاءً دُفِنَ الْمَيِّتْ, whether the deceased one was buried, أَوْ أَكَلَتْهُ السِّبَاعُ, or the wild animal ate him. مثلا, a person is found himself in the middle of the zoo, and the lion eat him up, right? Or he mentioned, حَفِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ, or fil bar, or in regard to the water, he says sawa an dufina al mayyit, whether he is being buried or he is being eaten by a wild animal, or it is on the water. Meaning that wild animals in the on the land, or in the sea, or the wild animal in the sea, or it has been taken away by the wind, meaning let's say he's burned to ashes and the wind took the spread out the ashes. So at any of this rate, the person will be asked. At any of this rate, the person will be asked. So he mentioned, Hafidhahullah, the important point also. He say, وَالظَّاهِرْ أَنَّ الْفِتَنْ. He say, what is appear here is that the trial, لَا يَكُونُ إِلَّا إِذَا انْتَهَتْ الْأَحْوَالُ الدُّنْيَوِي. He say here, what is appear is that the trial and the tribulation, it will not happen except when the situation of this life is over for the person. And وَسَلَمَ إِلَىٰ عَالَمُ الْآخَرِ, and he is heading to another stage. He is heading to another stage. Now, فَإِذَا تَأَخَّرَ دَفْنُهُ, if he is being delayed, if his burial is being delayed, whether يَوْمًا, whether it is a day, أو أكثر, or more than one day, لَمْ يَكُنْ سُؤَال, he will not be given the questions, hatta yudfan, until he will be buried. Very important point. If he died and they didn't bury him, whether it is a day or more, the questioner will not be established up until he is buried. Now, rahimahullah, this is what he mentioned. But if one were to ask, where is the dalil? فَمَاذَا نَقُولُ. نعم هذا كلام ابن تيمية. لا لا هنا هو هي. We're talking about that the asking will only happen after he's buried. Right? That's what the Sheikh said. He said even if the person is buried 2 or 3 days after his death, then this is when he will be asked. Not when, just right after he died. So, if we were asked, what is the dalil? فَمَاذَا نَقُولُ. That's a fact. That's a fact, but that's not, that's a fact, but not the hujjah. Huh? Where in the Quran?
How about the hadith, when they bury you, after the people left?
Ahsanta, very good. Now, where is that part of the hadith? That is the hujjah. Scratch your head again. فالآن يسأل فالآن يسأل فاسألوا الله لي صاحبكم الثبات. Ask Allah for your companion الثبات, meaning to be firm upon his tongue. فالآن يسأل. At this point on, he's being asked. And this was right after the day, bury him. Not when he was about to be buried, but when he was being buried. So the asking will happen when the person is buried. This is what we wanted to present in regard to, barakallahu fikum, the book that is Aqidatul Wasatiyya. Now they're coming back to our book, inshallah ta'ala, page number 126. Al-Rukun al-Sadis. The pillar number six. أن تؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. Believing in the divine decree, the good and the bad. شيخ صالح الفوضان حفظه الله, he mentioned, تؤمن بأن ما يجري في هذه الكون أو في هذا الكون من خير أو شر, من كفر وإيمان, من نعمة ونقمة, من راحة وشدة, من مرض وصحة, من حياة وموت, كل ما يجري في هذا الكون فإنه مقدور. He mentioned, حفظه الله, شيخ صالح الفوضان, he say, you believe, meaning believing in the predestination, the good and the bad, it is that you believe that everything that is going on this universe, everything that is going on in this universe, from good and bad, right? From good and bad. From disbelief and belief. From having favors and being indignation, meaning being in a situation of being and having been indignation. And likewise, raha, or raha, meaning be in the situation of ease, washidda, and being in the situation of difficulty. Min maradin, or being in the situation of yani being sick. Wasiha, or being in the situation of health. Min hayatin, or being alive. Or wa mautin, or in the situation of death. He say, kullun, every single thing that is going on in this kaun, he say, fa innahu maqdurun, it is being decreed. It is being decreed. Meaning everything that is going on in this kaun is being decreed. Right? Everything that is going on is decreed. If you're going to travel, when you're going to travel, what seat you're going to sit, who's going to be the pilot, everything is being decreed. Everything is being decreed. Every single thing is being decreed. Lam yakun sadfatan, and it is not something that just happened by chance or by accident. Meaning it is not something that is just accidentally happened. It just happened. So there is not such thing like it just happened. But rather everything that happened based on the divine decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore you cannot say it is by accident. أو يكون أمرا مستأنفا, or it is something that is done out of the ordinary, meaning it just happened. Meaning something, just like the French would say, azar. Right? There is no such thing as that. There is no such thing like it is, you know, out of the ordinary. It is out of the plan. It just happened to be. أي أنه مبتدئ لم يسبق أن قدر. He say, meaning that it is something that happened, that just started, and there was nothing that yani came before it to decree it. So therefore, تؤمن بهذا, that you will believe in this, كلها, all of it, كله, all of it, بأنه بقضاء الله وقدرته, that you will believe in this, وقدره, that you will believe all of this to be from the divine decree of Allah. And